A remotely operated vehicle of the U.S. Navy is set to arrive in the Philippine province of Oriental Mindoro. It will join efforts to clean up the oil spill from a tanker that sank 4 weeks ago. Dennis Dato reports.
More assets and experts are being poured into Oriental Mindoro to contain the oil spill and mitigate the impact to the environment and nearby communities. In the latest aerial survey done by the Philippine Coast Guard Wednesday morning at the disaster site, more than 5 kilometers of oil sheen can be seen. The Coast Guard has been using water cannons to dissolve the oil and prevent it from reaching the shore of other towns.
Sa dalawang pair ng ating mga may dalang oil spill boom sa recovery, may sunod-sunod din na barko rin ng Coast Guard na bumubomba naman sa mga oil sheens. These oil sheens, mabilis naman siya pag binulabog natin.
The Coast Guard now has 5 vessels in the waters of Pola Municipality where the MT Princess Empress sank after deploying 2 additional ships to expedite oil containment efforts. The South Korean Coast Guard has also arrived in the area. They are expected to provide technical advice to further improve the oil spill response. The United States Navy is also bringing in much-needed equipment and personnel. The U.S. Navy ship Pacific Valkyrie, carrying a remotely operated vehicle, or ROV, is currently in Subic. This ROV features full manipulator arms for oil containment and recovery, and it is expected to remove the remaining oil in the tanks of the submerged ship. It is expected to arrive in Oriental Mindoro on Monday. The ship also brought other assets including a harbor boom, a van for maintenance and repairs, and a decontamination van for oiled equipment. The U.S. Navy will also be deploying several boats and all-terrain vehicles. The PCG says operations will continue even during the Holy Week. In the meantime, residents of Batuhan Village in Pola are struggling to make ends meet. Almost 70% of residents in this village depend on the sea for their livelihood. But since the fishing ban was implemented, they are left with no other means to earn a living. Some children have also stopped going to school because money is tight for their families.
Bilang isa pong magulang ay masakit po sa akin na ang anak ko po ay mapatigil. Sayang naman po yung taon.
Pola Mayor Jennifer Cruz said they are looking for ways to help students affected by the oil spill.
Susubukan natin nakausapin mismo yung supervisor ng Oriental Mindoro ng DepEd para lang din, lalo yung even yung sa CHED, no, yung mga college natin, college students, nag-aaral sa iba't ibang bayan.
Dennis Dato, ABS-CBN News, Oriental Mindoro.
Moving on to more news, the country's water regulator assures affected residents that all efforts are being exhausted to alleviate the problems caused by daily water interruptions. Jervis Manahan tells us more.
Residents of Quezon City are struggling with water interruptions implemented by water concessionaire Maynilad to save water, as El Nino is projected to hit the country later this year. Some residents say they were not informed about the interruptions.
Hindi pa kami ready kasi naman na-abiso yung tubig na mawalan kayo ng tubig ngayong gabi, ganyan. Hindi kami na paghandaan.
Before nagkaganon na, ang ginawa namin, talagang magkuklose muna kami for the meantime na walang water.
On Wednesday, Water Regulator MWSS met with the water concessionaires to discuss the interruption. The MWSS says they are doing their best to shorten the duration of water interruptions so that water supply will return to normal. One possible solution is water sharing between the 2 concessionaires.
We try to get the assistance ng dalawang konsesyonaryo, magtulungan sila para po mabawasan po yung malawakang water interruption ng Maynilad. Meron po kasing possibility na si Manila Water po makapagbigay po ng tubig po na galing po sa cross-border ng system po nila.
They are also requesting the National Water Resources Board to increase allocation to help them improve water supply. But the NWRB earlier said they would have to decrease allocation to prepare for El Nino this year when less rainfall is expected.
Ang aim po ng MWSS dapat is wala po tayong water interruption sa kadahilan ng ang supply po naman natin sa Angat ay sufficient. Ngayon po, ang Maynila po, tinitignan din nila kung paano po yung future supply.
In a statement, Maynila warned longer water interruptions should be expected by April. Jervis Manahan, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine medical experts urge the public to prepare for tropical diseases brought by the El Nino phenomenon. Department of Health Officer in Charge Maria Rosario Virgere cited a variety of possible epidemics, such as cholera, dengue, malaria, and typhoid fever. She cautioned that most of these illnesses arise from the water crisis brought by the hot weather.
Most important would be na lahat tayo dapat aware tayo, lahat tayo alam natin ang gagawin natin kapag ka nangyari yan para maiwasan ang sakit. Katulad ng dapat siguraduhin lagi na ligtas ang tubig na ating iniinom. So it all boils down to good hygiene, good food preparation, and of course this source of water ay kailangan po laging malinis para maiwasan ang sakit.
The Philippine Federation of Professional Associations outlined some measures to avoid heat exhaustion. It noted that the most important is to stay hydrated by drinking at least 2 liters of water a day.
Huwag masyadong iinom at kakain ng matatamis kasi yun eh nakaka ano yung sugar mag ano niya yung tubig para ilabas. Oh. Kaya yung soft drinks din natin binibigay sa mga yung uhaw na uhaw kasi lalo kang uuhawin. Oh. Lalo yung alcohol, dapat bawasan ang alcohol during summer.
A group says the Philippine Education Department should look carefully into how they could revert the school summer break to April and May. Senate Education Committee Chairman Shirin De Chalian suggested that move following an incident at a school in Cabuyao, where several students were hospitalized after taking part in a fire drill. The National Parent Teacher Association says the Education Department should also take into consideration how learners will adapt to the adjustment.
Kung sakali implement next year yan, iurong natin to April to March, paano na yon? Paano na?
Baka po magkaroon ng transition. Oo,
oh. Matataman yung next school year na naman.
Mm-hmm.
Anong condition para talagang we will go back to that one? Sabi nila normal na ang ating, kasi mayroon ng face-to-face.
Mm-hmm.
But hindi pa rin normal with regards to the learners.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi may mga learners pa rin na mahinang magbasa at saka sa mathematics. Dapat din ang learners, kung na rin sila, adaptable na sila sa normal situation, pati pag-aaral.
The Teachers Dignity Coalition, meanwhile, welcomes the push to move the summer break to April and May.
Kailangan po nating maunawaan ano, na kakaiba po yung sitwasyon ng ating mga classrooms, no? Congested, no, hindi well ventilated, no, yung ating mga classrooms, no, marami po, no, yung ating mga mag-aaral, no, sa isang classroom at syempre karugtong po niyan kapag masyadong malaki yung bilang ng mga bata naglalabas din po ng init eh, no, yung katawan ng mga tao, no, and aside from the fact na talagang kulang po yung ating ventilation, kaya ganun po, no, naintindihan po natin yan at yan naman po yung lumalabas din naman, no, dun sa aming mga consultations sa our members.
Meanwhile, Senate Majority Leader Joel Villanueva is dismayed with owners of the sunken empty Princess Empress. That's after the contracted insurance corporation of RDC Rail Marine Services reportedly required the aggrieved fishermen to first sign a document that would bind them against filing a case against the company in exchange for compensation. Villanueva maintains RDC has a responsibility to help affected fishermen considering that they have lost their livelihood due to the spill.
If that is for real, hindi ho tama yun, no? The government should step up and make sure that we're protecting our fisher folks and we make sure that the full force of the law ma-implement. I hope and pray na yung mga fisher folks na nakaka-experience nito lumapit sa authority, no? Unak, hindi nila utang na loob na tinutulungan sila. Hindi po. At ito'y responsibilidad nitong kumpanya na ito at dapat lang silang kailangan nilang gawin ito.